Hello dear friends, today we'll tell about the experimental T-100 heavy tank. You will learn about the history of its creation and combat application. The experience of the Spanish Civil War showed that the armor of the T-35 heavy tank, considering its size, would not give it reliable protection against armor-piercing ammunition of modern rapid-fire anti-tank artillery of a caliber of 37 to 47 mm. Attempts to increase T-35 protection by means of screening and additional armor application led to the growth of combat weight and reduction of the vehicle mobility, and did not give the required effect. In this connection, the decision was taken to design a new heavy tank with a powerful armor and armament, a heavy breakthrough tank capable of operating in the most difficult fortified areas. Initially, a variant of mounting armament in three turrets was designed, a 37.2mm 10 gun in the main turret, and two 45mm 10 guns in two small turrets. However, after the design and layout review, in order to keep the weight of the vehicle below 55-57 tons, with an armor thickness of 60mm, one small turret was removed and further development work was done on the two-turret version. The layout of the tank differed from the conventional one by mounting armament in two conical turrets, located one behind the other in the longitudinal axis of the hull. The rear main turret of circular rotation was mounted on a high trunk. There was a driver mechanic in the front driving compartment along the axis of the vehicle, and there was a radio operator to his right. The fighting compartment was in the middle part of the hull and included the fighting compartments of two turrets. The main armament was a 76.2mm gun, and in the small turret a 45mm gun was used. The turrets had both electromechanical and manual turret actuators. In the rear part of the hull, a carbureted aviation 4-stroke 12-cylinder liquid-cooled V engine was installed. It had 850 horsepower at 1,800-500 revolutions per minute, and it also had a manual transmission. The T-100 tank with a weight of 58 tons could develop a maximum road speed of 35.7 km per hour and 10.3 km per hour on country roads. It also had good cross-country ability. After the beginning of the war with Finland, it was decided to send SMK tanks to the army for testing in combat conditions. We are talking about super heavy two-turret tanks T-100 and KV-1. In December 1939, during the battle, the SMK tank blew up on a mine and could not move anymore. The crew of the T-100 attempted to tow the SMK away with the help of other tanks, but these attempts were unsuccessful. After that, the T-100, standing next to the SMK and covering it with artillery and machine gun fire, provided evacuation of the crew of the knocked-out tank. The crew got out through escape hatches in the bottom of the vehicle and climbed inside the T-100. And the tank received at least 7 hits by 37mm and 47mm anti-tank guns from a distance of less than 500 meters. But the armor was never penetrated. After this battle, the T-100 was sent to the rear for engine repairs and was returned to the army on the 18th of February 1940. From this day until the end of hostilities, the T-100 acted as part of the 20th and 1st Tank Brigades. During this time, the tank covered 155 kilometers and received 14 hits by anti-tank guns. In all cases, the armor was not penetrated. All in all, by the 1st of April 1940, the T-100 ran 1,745 kilometers, of which 315 kilometers were spent during fights on the Karelian Isthmus. In general, T-100 was quite a successful machine. The tank in principle corresponded to operational and tactical views on its application. The tank's armor also met the requirements, and the armament allowed for a massive and maneuverable all-round shooting, which could be performed simultaneously in various directions. In all aspects, the T-100 was vastly superior to the T-35. However, the tank also had main shortcomings typical of tanks with several turrets. It was its large size, a large number of crew, and difficulty in production. Like the SMK, the T-100 was a necessary step on the way from multi-turreted heavy tanks to new types of heavy tanks, such as the KV-1. That's all for today. If you enjoyed the video, please support it with your likes and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you all later!